Mega Cleancast, the dankest clean for your glass.
Mr. Clean gets rid of dirt and grime and grease in just a minute. Mr. Clean will clean your whole house with everything in it.
Everyone, and welcome to another episode of Mega Cleancast, the internet's number one podcast dedicated to cleaning. I'm Steamcleaner Marv, and with me as always are Mop Master Lewis.
Great to be here, Marv.
Big Brillo Scrubs.
Good cleans to you, sirs.
And chemically sanitized Paul.
How's it going, bros?
I'm glad to be back here with you guys. We haven't done a clean cast in quite a while, so I'm sure everyone's been getting up to some interesting antics. How about you, Lewis?
Well, it's nice that you asked that, because I actually had a job for a while at University of Greenville.
Prestigious.
As a janitor, and I would spend most of my time just writing equations on boards, but I got fired because I would do this at like home ec. And they didn't like that.
Yeah, only formula they're interested in is baby formula.
But I'll tell you what, I could clean those toilets really well. So, fuck you, Greenville U.
Yeah, I've seen Lewis's toilet job, man.
Oh, a toilet job? Yeah, he does give a hell of a blumpkin. Isn't that what they call a toilet job? A blumpkin?
Yes, I believe so.
Have you seen his rims? Ooh, his toilet rim job?
Yeah, I could really clean those rims real well.
Well, I've given a few rim jobs in my life, and no asshole has ever been cleaned quite as bad, and by bad, I mean good, as Lewis's asshole.
Brilly. Can I call you Brilly?
Well, Brillo's tends to be more formal. I'll accept Brilly.
Okay.
This is a pretty casual clean cast.
Yeah, very casual. Normie, you could say. So what have you been doing, other than avoiding my question?
You know, I am the newest member of the clean cast.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of our longtime viewers will know I just got into the cleaning game. So just this past week, I finally got all the pizza boxes out of my room.
Yeah, that's great. That was quite a collection you had.
Yeah, I was collecting them for about a year. They're finally cleared out. It's great. It's very it's pretty tidy in here.
It's a good start, Brilly.
So did you abandon the pizza box fort?
No, well, that was never in the bedroom, so
oh.
It's still there in the living room.
Oh, okay, great, good. Because, I mean, where are we going to do rim jobs?
Yeah, exactly. Rim jobs in the pizza box fort. Just rolls off the tongue.
Well, I'm glad you've joined us in our cleaning crusade there, Brillo. Paul, how about you? What have you been up to?
You know, the usual. Just been working overnight at my local motel, where I also live.
Nice.
And, well, I have to say, I've been cleaning the shit out of some toilets. Metaphorically and literally.
Just like Lewis.
Yep. Well, it turns out, when you embark on a career of cleaning, a lot of it is just cleaning human feces out of various sort of, you know, places.
Like crevices.
Yeah, like toilets and like your
underwear.
Like the pavement and the floor of the cafeteria at the mental institution that you work at.
I thought you worked at a motel.
Well, both. I moonlight at a motel and I daytime at a mental institution.
It's working two jobs, man. Times are tough.
So you're splitting your time between...
Yeah, that's what I just fucking said, Lewis. So you don't have to, like, rub it in, my dude.
And you know, Paul, there's also the metaphorical toilets you spoke of. We gotta clean out the dark recesses of our souls.
Yeah, but mostly shit.
Yeah, but mostly literal shit, yeah.
Well, it's rewarding, though, to get the feces up. Like, I understand nobody wants to touch feces, but once the feces are, you know, in the trash can or in the garbage disposal or...
Absolutely.
It's like the scholar Confucius says.
Oh, and the other thing he said, man who stand on toilet, high on pot.
That's a good one.
He did say that.
Yes.
He did. I heard him.
I was there.
Oh, well, you know, speaking of feces, I stepped in some recently.
Nice.
And I managed to clean it off my shoe, but I'd much rather have stepped into the clean box.
You just stepped into the clean box.
And welcome to the Clean Box, where we rate various cleaning products and other products for cleaning. That's what we do, right?
Sounds about right.
That's the Clean Box.
Every episode.
All right, so our first clean is Clorox Disinfecting Wipes. Now, these come in three flavors, yellow, green, and which I believe is mint, and yellow.
My favorite three flavors.
I like the mints because they clear the palate. After, you know, having some nice bleach.
I actually prefer the yellow brand Clorox Disinfecting Wipes.
Sorry, I think you mean yellow flavor.
Sorry, yellow flavor Clorox Disinfecting Wipes. When I masturbate, it has a quality finish that is unmatched by any other competing disinfectant wipe.
It has a little bit of a sting to the tip of your penis.
Ooh, just that little sting just,
Burns so good.
It burns hot and it burns dry.
That's what you want, right? There's something to be said about the pairing of the yellow flavor and the teal flavor or green or whatever that is. Mm-hmm. Yellow is a bit overwhelming as a flavor, and then you want to like sort of bring it back a little bit with the green.
Yeah, you can really dial it in.
Yeah, but then after the green, you're like, well, fuck, I want some more yellow, please. And then you have more yellow. And that's why you have the yellow-green-yellow combination. It's like it's a great platter. It's a great pairing.
This is a household combination. Everyone knows it. Mm-hmm. Everyone loves it.
Yeah, you gotta have this in your cleaning cabinet.
So, what do we rate this at, guys?
Oh, I've gotta give it. I gotta give it a 99.999% of all germs.
I gotta give this a yellow. Menthol yellow rating.
While these are great for cleaning your tough kitchen stains, not so good for cleaning your butt.
I have to agree. I've tried, but it was not a good experience.
The hot, dry sting that I mentioned earlier, great for the weenie, bad for the...
In-betweeny.
Fuck this clean. Next clean, please.
All right, and next on our list we have Tide Pods.
You know, they say it right on the package. This stuff is for downies.
Yeah, for me, these are, if you're not using traditional laundry detergent, either in liquid or powder form, then you're a normie and you can GTFO.
I like to use this as my contact lens solution, just to clean my eyes out before I put my contacts in.
They're little packets.
The pod?
Yeah, you know, I kind of just squeeze it with my fist into my contact case, and I mix it up, and I put my contact lenses in there a little bit, just to get that nice, bleachy consistency. I put it directly in my eye after that.
I've never considered using it for that. I finished. I've never considered using it for that.
Oh, well, it's great.
Yeah, and what's really awesome is that because your eyeballs are in such close proximity to your nose or nostril enclosure, the scientific term, you can actually smell that great Tide scent.
Well, I happen to think that this is cultural appropriation of people with Down syndrome, and I do not appreciate it whatsoever.
Sounds like the cops have gone after you for that comment there, Paul.
I can't help it. I live in a big city.
Oh, it's the PC police.
Oh, no. I just made a bad word.
Oh, it's a microaggression.
Oh, it wasn't a microaggression. It was a macroaggression, my dude.
Now that you've confessed, I don't hear them anymore, so they must have gone away.
Here's my personal take on the pods. Like I said, if you're not using traditional laundry detergents, you don't know jack about cleaning. Like, I could see Brilli thinking this is okay to use, but for a Lewis or Paul, or Marv. I mean, there's just no question we wouldn't touch this stuff. So when somebody gave me some, I put them on the lowest shelf in the pantry and left the lid open. Kids love them. Got a great candy kind of flavor. It's awesome. So great snack for small children.
You know, I remember as a kid chowing down on these Tide Pods. I couldn't get enough of them.
They really clean you out. It's nice.
I give Tide Pods a 4.1 out of 4.1.
Mmm, perfect score.
Ah, high rating.
But that's a bold move there, Paul.
It's a bold move, Cotton.
Speaking of cotton, our next meme are microfiber cleaning slippers. Ooh.
Ooh. Oh, wow.
Ooh.
Ah. These must be some expensive slippers.
Who designed these? Is this Armani?
No, I believe that's Gucci. Or Dolce & Gabbana.
Oh, okay. Now, I like the... I think I know what these are for. I think what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to wear these while you're swimming to clean the pool.
Oh, yeah. I like to wear shoes when I'm swimming. Nothing says you're cooler than wearing both your shoes and your t-shirt when you get into a swimming pool.
I hear that.
How accurate of life.
These are also great if you need extra hair for your homemade Muppet.
Oh, yeah. You can, like, get those off and make it like the chest hair for...
Kermit the Frog.
That's the one thing missing from all good children's puppet shows.
Is sexualized chest hair.
Yeah. Sometimes I like to go hiking over in Greenville Volcano area.
Mm-hmm.
But I always see all this trash and stuff near the lava.
Oh, yeah, they're horrible. People just have no respect for the volcanic area.
I think I would like to wear these in the volcano sometime. Because I think this would help clean up the volcano a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the microfibers look like they'd absorb... everything but the hot lava.
Yeah, that's a steamy idea. I like it.
Paul, do you think these are good for anything else?
Nope, next meme, please.
All right, our next clean is, oh, boo, the Roomba.
Boo. Fuck
this.
Trying to take our jobs.
Meme clean.
My mom bought one of these things, and it's just ruined my life.
My mom bought one of these things, and it went into my room when I was sleeping, and it started bumping into the wall, and then it swept up, like, 3 of my Pokemon cards, and I was not impressed.
Mm-mm. Not a fan of that.
Another downside to the Roomba, I don't know if you guys know this, this does not come with what every good vacuum cleaner comes with.
Oh, yeah?
The fellatio hose.
The fellatio, of course.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Well, there's one company that does that well, and that is Dyson. Mm-hmm. Dyson has a solid fellatio ratio when you're, you're looking for a little good time,
I mean,
you know?
Here's the thing. A lot of people think that's kind of weird.
It's right? not
to,
weird.
To be fellated by, I'm just cleaning it. It's mine, and I can clean it if I want to.
Yeah, and those people who think it's weird are racist.
Yeah, what is weird is when you walk in and catch your grandpa with the Roomba in his lap. Very uncomfortable.
It's a bit weird, but, you know, we have to be more accepting as a culture and accept that sometimes people want to get jerked off by Dyson vacuum cleaners.
You know what? You're right. I apologize to my grandpa. Sorry, Pop. I probably just triggered you talking about that, and I'm sorry.
He's an older generation, so it's not as accepting, you know what I mean?
Actually, let me repeat that. He's not going to be able to hear that. Pop, I'm sorry.
You better send him a telegram, too.
I'll do that. I will. Let me just call Western Union.
I tried to get this thing to make me, like, a Tide martini, you know, with some Tide, a little bit of Ajax.
Yeah?
But it was using Downy instead.
Oh.
So I just, like, I just threw it at it.
Fuck off with the Downy.
Blech. You just can't get good robot service these days.
Yeah, we should bring back, like, human servants. Those work better.
Yeah, here's the thing. We need to... We honestly, though, like, the Roombas, they're taking our jobs.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to build a wall around
the
Roombas.
Yep.
So that they won't take our jobs. And I think we should start with Boston Dynamics. Have you seen what they're doing lately? They're doing more than just vacuuming. They're hiking. And they're walking. And they're collecting predetermined items. They're unloading trucks, kind of.
Oh, they're withstanding brutal kicks.
Oh yeah, there's this one video surfacing around the internet nowadays.
Oh, the one with the two girls in the cup.
Yeah, and then the Boston Dynamics robot.
Yeah, and there's something has to be done about the two girls in the cup.
He fucking grabs the cup and he runs off. Those girls are out of a job now.
Thanks to Roomba and Boston Dynamics and Google.
Wait, and now Lewis is out of a job. Who do you think cleans up after the two girls in the cup?
That's why you had to go to the university.
Yeah, I mean, Greenville U, you know, they fired me. But I'm pretty sure Roomba's had something to do with it. Clearly.
This is why I voted for Donald Dyson. The heir of Dyson Industries.
He knows to put manual cleaning first.
Honestly, if you don't support Donald Dyson, the heir of Dyson Industries, then honestly, you're just a communist and should be executed. Moving on, next meme, please.
And our next meme is the pressure washer. This thing will rip your foreskin right off. Just rip it right off.
I'm just gonna...
You can tell that Brillo has never cleaned his deck before.
I don't even have a deck, bro.
Yes, you do have a deck.
Well, your parents do.
You know, it's the terror of knowing what the world's about.
Our next clean is... Oh, our final clean in the clean box is lie.
Yeah, I don't much believe in this product.
You know, I can't lie about this one.
Oh, you're a total liar. As much as you clean commodes and similar jobs, you definitely lie.
You know what, Lewis? You gotta just lie down once in a while, huh?
You know, I like lie, and I cannot lie. All you other cleaners can't deny.
Can't deny. This shit tastes bad.
I only like lye because you can make soap, and soap is great for cleaning things.
Sometimes I feel like it's time for me to lie down, so I just take a big bottle of this and just like put it all over myself.
In the words of Lindsay Buckingham, tell me lies, tell me sweet little lies.
That was Fleetwood Whack.
No, that was Fleetwood fucking Mac Daddy. Next meme, please.
And we're out of memes, and so that means that's it for the clean box.
Yeah, we really cleaned up that box.
Yeah.
We really cleaned the shit out of that fucking box, if you know what I mean. I'm talking about pussy.
We got all up in that box and just cleared it out. Whatever remnants were left from before us, we went in and just scraped them out. Before we leave the clean box, I have to tell you that today's clean box segment was brought to you by Greg's Great Memes.
Oh, I love that page.
Mm. This is a wonderful page. So many great memes on this page. You have to check it out. Just go to Facebook and then type in at the top Greg's Great Memes, because I'm too lazy to find the URL.
You want to go to www.audible.com.
Mm-hmm.
Type in the coupon code Greg's Great Memes. It's a secret website on the Audible website.
Perfect.
And you'll be able to find it there.
Well, great. So disregard my instructions. Do what Brillo said. It's a great meme site. We all personally can vouch that these are like where some of the best memes are.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, we're not particularly known for our knowledge or interest in memes, but
of course not.
My good friend and former Mega Cleancast intern Karma Clean Alex, he is a big fan of memes, and he gave this 5 out of 5 memes.
No, I'm not sure what that rating means.
Wait. 5 out of 5 out of what though?
5 out of 5 out of 5 memes.
Oh, okay. Wait. 5 out of 5 out of 5 out of what, though?
5 out of 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 5 memes by Mega Cleancast intern Karma Clean Alex. So if the site sucks, blame him, not me. They paid us to say this anyway.
Yeah, fuck that guy.
Yeah, it's a sponsor.
Yeah, thanks, Squarespace.
see the sponsored content label in the bottom corner?
Get fucked, Audible.
Yeah.
And since Audible's not around anymore to tell us what we can or can't do, we're finally going to let Lewis have his own segment, Mop Talk. Now here's the totally amazing Mop Talk theme song performed live by Chemically Sanitized Paul. Go, Paul.
All right, here we go. Tell me lies, tell me sweet little lies. Tell me lies. Tell me lies, tell me sweet little lies. All right. You just stepped into the whatever the fuck was just mop talk. That's, here we go. Let's do it.
Yo, it's your boy Mop Master Lewis. I'm a mop expert and I will review mops from my mop collection. Look at this one right here. I call it Big Bird.
Damn.
It's really rare. It's a feather mop. It's not very good when you get it wet, though.
Kind of like your mom, huh?
Yeah, exactly like my mom.
Wait, a mop that gets worse the wetter it gets?
Brillo, you don't know anything about mops. Let him talk.
I know, right? It's a one-of-a-kind mop. It's good because it's rare. There's no other mop like it in the world. However, it's not very good at cleaning your floor because it's too small. Like, if you're like a tiny man, it's great. If you're like a regular sized person with a regular size apartment, not so great. It's good at tickling though. You can tickle somebody with it.
Well, that's useful. I have a question though.
Go ahead.
Could I fly on this, or is that like totally relegated to brooms?
You need two.
Okay.
Yeah, you need two. You need to flap your arms with them.
Too rich for my blood.
What can I do with just one?
Not very much. You can look at it. Actually, don't look at it. Don't touch it. I see you looking at it, Billy.
I think you mean Brilly.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was talking to somebody behind you named Billy.
Oh yeah, there's Billy. Yeah, behind me.
Hey, Billy, get out of here. We're recording our clean cast. Next mop, please.
Anyway, that's Big Bird. Yeah, this one here is my mop elemental. Now, this is really useful. If you summon this, it will clean the floor for you. However, it needs a lot of food and attention once you summon it, and then like afterward, it'll just like run around and pee on the floor. But in theory, it's really useful.
If you now, could... Oh, go ahead. Go ahead, Brillo. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. I feel like I've interrupted you a lot.
Now you talk or I'm going to feel disrespected.
Okay, I'll talk. Now, if I summon this mop, and I did not feed it, could I use it as a regular mop?
Yes. I would not recommend it, though, because there's, like, smells and stuff, and it's probably, like, not good for you to, like, be treating Mop Elemental so badly. They have a really, really good union, so you don't want
to... Yeah, I might have to call the ASPCME.
Yeah, lots of people really like mops, so if you treat them badly, they'll bust down your door.
I got a question. Is this like a Rasta mop?
No.
Okay.
It's not.
Okay. So it doesn't smoke pot.
Yeah, I think you're thinking of a Bob Mopley.
I was thinking about him.
It's the other model.
Yeah, I got a question.
Go ahead.
Is this mop connected in any way whatsoever to the mop's childs?
You mean the conspiracy where, you know, they mop a lot of stuff and...
Well, not a conspiracy. Oh, okay. Not a conspiracy, Lewis. That's mighty fine for you to dismiss it as such. But I've heard a lot of things about this mopspiracy. And look, let's be real here. Can you provide evidence that Seth Rich wasn't murdered by the Mopschilds?
I'm going to clear this up right now. Yes, he was. It's all true.
All right.
Where was your mop elemental on 9/11?
In the same room with Bin Laden's father.
Got me on the spot here. I don't know. I should ask it.
Why don't you recite the spell that summons the mop elemental so that you can ask it?
Okay. Here goes. Mappa, mappa, mappa. Latiname, papa.
Latiname, papa.
Oh, there it is. Okay. All right. Where were you on 9/11? Okay, he was there. He did it. So that answers your question.
I knew it the whole time.
Ah, fucking mops child.
Well, he cleans the floor pretty good though, so good for him.
Yeah, he cleaned the floor with those towers too. Am I right?
Cleaned all 220 floors.
Let's move on to the next mop.
Too soon. Only been 16 years.
A little too soon, guys. I'd call this one the sucker.
Got my interest.
It's an unusual rubber mop from Canada. It's a 1959 model. It's not really good at cleaning. It'll suck on the floor, but the dirt doesn't go anywhere. It just stays right under the mop. It's actually really good for pranks though, because before the show, we stuck one onto Brilly's body, and I don't think he's noticed yet.
Wait. What, really?
Hey, look, he still hasn't actually noticed. He heard what you said, but he hasn't found it.
Really, it's right there.
It's right there, dude.
Just pull it off.
It's got to be under one of the folds here. Just a second. No, I'm not finding it.
Just look under there.
I think...
Yeah, under. You got to lift. There, next to the bed sore.
I'll lift this part here.
I think earlier I felt something... enter my asshole.
I was just looking at this thing. I was thinking this would be really useful if it would stick to the side of my shower.
Well, that's a sucker for you. I mean, you guys have any questions?
Where can I buy one?
You can't. Yeah, they're out of print.
How did this fucking thing worm itself into my asshole is my question.
That might be a better question for your asshole.
Yeah, we put it on your back, so I don't know how it got in there. I think it migrated down there.
I might have to see a doctor.
Billy, I'll call for you since your fingers are inexcusably fat.
Maybe we'll finally get Dr. Flatskin on the show like all the fans have been requesting.
Well, actually, the fans have been requesting Dr. Drew, but we can get Dr. Flatskin instead.
We'll get Dr. Flatskin in on our next episode, guaranteed.
I'll get him on the show. I'll get Dr. Flatskin on the show if my name isn't Fuck You... moving on. Next mop, please.
Okay, this mop is called the Dragon.
Ooh, that's a hot mop.
It's a powerful Chinese fire mop. This one goes to 11. Now, if you use this, you're kind of a showboat, kind of a show-off. It's good for wood floors. It's great for gasoline spills, wood floors.
Circus act.
And it's just always on fire. I've never really seen it not on fire, so I'm not sure what's going on with that one, but it's the Dragon. I'm not sure. I don't remember buying this one. I don't know what it is. But let's test it out, okay?
Let's give it a shot.
Mm-hmm.
All right,
I don't
know
how this works. I think that's the wrong end.
Dipping it in water.
No, that's the wrong end.
No, I'm pretty sure this is the right end.
No, you have to
put
the other end.
You gotta light it.
I think I know how to use a mop.
No,
I'm
that's the
mop
last
master.
One, Paul. Paul, you light the last one. This one... Okay. Wait, try putting it in the water sideways.
Okay, yeah, sure.
There you go.
Wait a minute. Is this right?
I mean...
Does there have to be water in the bucket? No.
Right? Oh, there's no water. You gotta put water in the bucket.
Do I put it on the mop first and then put it in the bucket?
I think you gotta put the crab in the bucket.
Where'd the crab come from?
No, I need several crabs so they stay in there together. Right?
Oh yeah, you can't put just one crab.
Yeah, it's like...
It'll just get out.
You gotta just put at least two crabs so they each have each other.
They're like guinea pigs, they get lonesome.
Alright, so I got a crab-filled bucket. I'm putting it in there sideways, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there's crabs on it now, so I think it's pretty good. Pretty good at its job.
Yeah?
Yeah, I mean, it seems okay.
Keep going, then. Keep going.
So I like also, I don't know what the fuck it is.
Well, see if it can clean up this sweat pool over here near Brillo.
Sure. This is how I do it, right?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Bang it on the ground.
It's...
Okay, well, I think that works. So, pretty good. Don't know how it got here.
Yeah, I've got to give this... This is like a 10 out of 12.
Is this... Is this one of your guys' mops? Like,
No. I don't know if that's a mop, actually.
I don't own a mop.
Is this like a gorilla art piece someone put in here? Like, what's this doing in my mop collection?
That's racist.
Well, against gorillas?
Hey!
I guess this is an okay.
Turn it down, my dude.
Brillo. Dude.
This is a free speech zone, but also we
clean it up there, buddy.
Take things
you need
seriously
to be more sensitive
here.
Of you fat tub of shit.
Okay, is this the last fucking mop? Can we get out of this fucking mop house?
Yeah. I don't ever want to hear about another mop for the rest of my life, Lewis.
All right, guys, get the fuck out of my mop room.
This is the worst idea.
You're all banned from the mop room, okay?
All right, next mop, please.
No, we're out of mops. No more mops. Well, now that I'm completely burned out, kind of like the dragon mop, on Lewis's stupid mop collection. Fuck you, Lewis.
Hey, my mops are awesome.
No, they're not. I'm going to break them while you sleep tonight.
You just don't understand my mops, okay?
You don't understand what I'm going to do to those mops while you're in fucking dreamland.
You wouldn't dare.
I will put each and every one of them up my anus one at a time.
Dude, he's not fucking bluffing.
I'm not. I'm starting right now. Hand me the dragon.
Hand him that shit, man.
But before I start sodomizing myself with Lewis's mop collection, I think it's time for Lay New Clean.
I think it's time for Lay New Clean.
Know what Lay New Clean is. So, guys, any ideas?
A tactical cleaning nuke makes a lot of stuff clean. Big area.
A large scale cleaning nuke.
That's right.
I'm pretty sure that's already made, Lewis. They dropped two in Japan in like the 50s.
Oh, never mind then. That's Lay Old Clean. We should move on.
I think we should run a microfiber cloth through a shredder and eat all the pieces so it cleans you from the inside out.
That sounds awesome. Just feeling all that microfiber cloth just scratching your inside clean.
Yep.
That'd be
and then
great.
Trying to poop it out slowly.
Just having it all scrape inside you like that.
Paul, I don't hear you mmming.
Want to make kind of mmm sound, Paul?
Well, folks, I'm going down to St. James Infirmary. See my baby! Cream corn!
Alrighty.
Yep.
And that's it for Lay New Clean.
Pretty tidy clean.
I feel like Lay New Clean's gonna get cut. And now is the time in the CleanCast where we take some viewer cleaning questions. Joanna asks, what's the best way to clean kitchen floors?
Women.
Should have known that, Joanna.
If you don't got no women in your life, I suggest a solution of Coke Zero, hydrochloric acid, depression and self-hate. Just swirl that up. Bake it in the oven for 20 minutes at 400 degrees. When you have your steaming pile of cleaning solution, just throw it on the floor, let it sit for 2 or 3 days, and then use the microfibers that you just swallowed and shit back out to clean it all up.
Pharmaceutical companies. Dirk wants to know, my dog is shedding for the summer. How can I minimize pet hair in my carpets and on my furniture? That's easy. Just take your dog outside and kill it.
Whenever my dog sheds his skin, I just use that skin as a couch cover. The stuff he leaves behind.
Lewis, I think that's a snake.
I'm pretty sure it's a dog.
No, you have a pet snake. I've seen it.
No. I know what a dog is.
So what a snake is. It's the thing you have.
So you have a...
No.
You have a hairless dog that just has no legs.
Yes.
Does it hiss at you or does it bark at you?
Oh, no. It has a bark. It just sounds like this.
I've got the question that will for sure settle this.
Okay.
Is its tongue often outside of its mouth?
Yes.
Oh, definitely a snake.
Yeah, that sounds like a snake.
Yeah, dogs never do that. Sorry, Lewis.
Darn, I guess I should have done my homework, I think. And this whole dog snake thing.
Clarice wants to know, any tits for cleaning out my fridge and freezer?
Yeah, I got a couple tits.
Yeah, stop being such a slobby-ass fucking thought.
Oh, I said tits. Tips. With a puh.
You know, I think Paul has a story, actually, about cleaning out your fridge and freezer.
What?
Do tell.
Okay, well, alright, so, look, I'm not the cleanliest guy, but, you know what, I have a fridge as much as the next guy, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I went to my fridge, and I opened it up, and there was a bunch of rotten food in there. And I went,
normal.
Okay, well, why is there a bunch of rotten food in my fridge? And the answer to that question was, because I've been unemployed for 6 months, and I didn't do groceries, and I also didn't cook myself any food in my house, so I just let the food in my fridge rot. Long story short, I had to take all that food out of the fridge, and there was like maggots and shit in it, and it was like gross, and there was like spoiled milk, and at the end of the day, so the moral of the story is, I took out all the gross rotten food and I put different food in there.
Hey, that's a really good way to handle that. I would not have approached it that way myself, though.
Well, I couldn't have done it if it wasn't for Brillo scrubs, which I used to scrub the mold out of my fridge. Thanks, Brillo.
Yeah, Brillo scrubs are awesome. Now, big Brillo scrub sucks.
Yep, that's right. I substitute as a great vacuum cleaner.
Now, if he was tiny Brillo scrubs, and it was one of those older fridges, what you could do is you could just put him in that fridge and close the door behind him and lock it. He would just clean it out from the inside for you. A week or two later, you could take him out, and you know, fridge is clean, and everyone's happy.
Yeah, but now instead of a tiny Brillo scrubs, you have a big Brillo scrubs.
Right, and you can't fit in there.
No, and you can't, but that's not a problem because you don't actually have to put big Brillo scrubs in your refrigerator or freezer for him to clear them out. Just invite him over to your house for a little while. He will clear them both out quickly.
Interesting.
It's true.
He went into the pantry and ate the cans. Whole.
And the Tide Pods.
Hey, those were for the kids, Brillo.
They're good, though.
I guess he's just a natural cleaner, then.
So our final question from viewer Josh. Josh inquires, how often should I replace my dishwashing sponge?
The answer is never, because what happens with the dishwasher sponge is that you build a bacteria, and now some, and I'm talking about some people who are in some parentheses, would say that changing your sponge is a necessity to remain hygiene, but that's not true.
You know that the people telling you that work in the military industrial sanitation complex.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. I don't need to get into it.
And I also know this, that much like using a cast iron pan, the more buildup you have, the more flavor the sponge will impart into your food.
I have to agree with both Marv and Paul.
Thank you.
You see, what happens is when you wash those dishes with your sponge, you're putting soap on it. So at that moment, Your soapy sponge is the cleanest thing in the house. Why would you clean that with anything else?
It builds an immunity with each wash.
You can't, because it's already the cleanest thing there.
It's a sponge,
If it touches anything else, it's just clean it with itself. Oh, wow.
You take the sponge, you fold it in half, and you clean it. Well, it's okay. We feel strongly about not replacing dishwasher sponges. In fact, we all feel so strongly about it that we all took the I'll never replace my dishwashing sponge oath. And nothing would please me more than for all of us to simultaneously recite that pledge at this very moment.
Oh, okay.
Let's do it.
I solemnly swear. I will never replace my dishwashing sponge. If I am ever to replace it, I agree to be hanged until dead.
And now that we've gotten that out of our system, I think it's time we wrap things up with Tidy or Shitey.
Ooh.
I love this segment.
Wow, this is my favorite segment. Out of all the years we've been doing Tidy or Shitey, I have to say, this is my favorite shit.
As a mop master, I like to critique other people's cleaning, so this is a great segment for me to
enjoy. As a mop master reviewer, I may not be a mop master, but I'm a mop master reviewer. I have to say this is my favorite review show, and that is my credentials as a mop master reviewer, a mop master critic. I went to school for the craft. Yes, I participated in many classes by such mop masters as Dyson himself spoke at the university I went to. But Lewis, let's hear what you have to say.
Welcome to Tidy or Shitey, where we review rooms that are either really clean or really gross.
Yeah, you would say
that. Is it tidy or shitey?
And that's what we do. Our first one, here you go. Wow.
Ugh.
Wow.
Ugh.
Just.
Barf.
Here's what I think about that.
Did you just fart?
Yes.
Though, look at that. The floor is just covered in shitey.
It is absolutely disgusting. It looks like Billy slept on the floor.
Okay, you notice how the pillows are arranged symmetrically? That's bull crap.
Oh, there's Vanta Black on the wall. Do you guys see the Vanta Black?
That's a big no-no. They didn't even clean the Vanta Black off the wall.
You can't scrub that stuff off. I mean, it's tough. You can't even get it with a Mr. Clean Magic Eraser.
And it spreads, too. That thing's going to be all black by next Tuesday.
I just want to say that the fireplace is merely an aesthetic choice because, honestly, an electronic fireplace in a modern apartment, a modern condo, or even a modern house is not going to produce any heat value whatsoever, and it's probably going to surge your heat bill over the top. So this is clearly for aesthetic reasons, and I have to say, well done.
Now, I'm noticing outside of the window there that this is not a luxury apartment on, like, the 58th floor overlooking Central Park. Therefore, this room is shitey.
I think what could really save this room is if instead of those windows, there were just more fireplaces.
It would definitely help.
Yeah, you know what? It's great. It has a great aesthetic appeal. And honestly, like, one's not enough to produce the right amount of heat that you need. So maybe two, maybe three.
Maybe they should just turn the entire lawn into a fireplace. I think I'll go over there right now and do it.
Now, this ottoman in the center of the room, I feel like it needs a giant, like, I don't know, chocolate wafer on top and bottom, and it would be an awesome ottoman ice cream sandwich.
And you know, I think they've thrown out too many throw pillows. Take at least half of them away.
Yeah, you know, there's too many there, and they should toss them out. They really ottoman, man. I think I think whoever painted this room committed a major fox pass, because you don't want to paint a room white, because if you're trying to keep that room clean, white actually works against you, because white people will come in here and dirty it up. They think the white is calling them.
Funnily enough, I'm pretty sure I looked at the floor plan and the wall plan and the ceiling plan of this place.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's actually supposed to be red. So I think this white is just like bird shit or something. It's bird crap. Just
oh,
all over
disgusting.
The place.
This room is so shiny.
Super
I'm
shiny.
Ready for an, I'm ready for my next
yeah.
room.
So wait, we gotta rate it. Tidy or shiny?
Shiny.
Shizen!
And our next room, wow. All I can say is, wow.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty nice. Wow.
Yeah, I mean, I really don't see the problem here.
Yeah.
You know, it's almost perfect in a way. Just the delicate layout, each thing, perfect where it needs to be.
Yeah, it's got a real feng shui going on here.
Yep.
I think whoever has this room has the system, and the system is flawless. You gotta trust the process.
If you look at the upper left, you may just catch there the bottom of a very nice katana.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah. So that tells you a lot about the person who owns this delightful room. Tidy.
Mm-hmm.
Very tidy.
Tidy.
I, as a cleaning expert, would have nothing to do here if I was hired by this person.
Yep. You give that man his money back and you go home.
I'd take his money, but I wouldn't clean anything.
Now, if I can point out one small detail that's bothering me here, there does appear to be some sort of food wrapper that's visible that should have been put in the trash can. But other than that, I mean, we're looking at, you know, a 9.9 out of 10.5.
Oh, yeah, it's not perfect, but nobody is.
But it's definitely tidy. Definitely tidy.
Yeah, tidy.
Yeah, I give it a 46% out of 24.
Well, that's more than double.
Yeah, so pretty good.
All right, well, okay, so this is going to be a little bit of a tangent, per se.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
No, never.
You're not known for those, Paul.
No. But, all right, so I don't know if you guys have heard of the guy, a man named Fritz Haber.
Nope.
So Fritz Haber, he was a chemist. He received the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 1918. And, well, he created the gases Zyklon A and Zyklon B. And basically what I'm saying is that Fritz Haber, I mean, he's got his tag all over this image. I see, like, the key tells of a Fritz Haber gas, Zyklon B, is like sort of like a blue stain on the walls, and I see a little bit of blue stain on the walls in this image.
You're right.
So
You're right.
Yeah, like Fritz Haber has his name all over this, and I just want to say that maybe chemistry isn't dead. Maybe some Nobel Peace Prize winning chemists, you know, they're alive and well in our on our rooms here. So
wow, I'm just I don't know what to say. That's we really should just cancel the rest of this podcast.
Paul, you always amaze me with the amount of autism in you.
Sorry.
That's a little insensitive, but
I was just releasing a little Zyklon B there. So, Paul, you didn't answer, though. Tidy or shiny?
Tidy.
We agree. Definitely agree. Let's take a look at this next one. Oh, what do you know?
Hey, this looks familiar.
This does look familiar. Because I only know one person who owns two 1990s stereo systems.
Wait. When did you guys take this?
Earlier today.
I've been in my room all day. Oh my god. This is when I was grabbing the Cheetos, wasn't it? Like 5 minutes.
Yeah, no, come on, be real. That was like 15 minutes. You had to drag yourself.
All right, yeah, this is... Okay. All right, everyone. This is a genuine photo of Big Brillo Scrubs this room, okay?
And I know what people are thinking, Brillo. They're thinking, Shitey, right? because there's drink cups on your desk, and I mean, you know. But you're wrong.
I consume a lot of Coke Zero, and I need at least two cups, because I'd rather not make so many trips to the kitchen.
I can understand that. If I had to drag myself from room to room, I wouldn't want to either.
That's why the cups are there. The Cheetos are also kept in the kitchen.
Well, to be fair, we know what the third cup is for, Billy, because you don't want to drag yourself to the bathroom either.
Well, yeah.
That's perfectly reasonable.
You know, I always forget which cup is which, though. I'm looking at them right now. I'm not sure.
Now, as much as I would love to discuss all the fine details in this image, the one thing that really pops out to me is I would love for you to spend 15 to 20 minutes discussing the animu that's on the wall.
Actually, Marv, do you mind blurring that out in post there?
Which, blur what out?
Well, the girl right above my bed. She's not to be seen by others. That is my waifu.
Oh, okay, I'll blur it out right now.
That's much better, thank you. Thank you, Marv.
Yeah, now no one will ever see her.
I like the way all these old anime video games and dinosaurs are arranged in alphabetical order, but
the
Japanese alphabet.
Lewis, you're a fan. So
that's pretty good. No, I'm not. I just, I know things, though.
But Brillo, I do notice here that none of the clothing on that bed would possibly fit on your enormous body, other than maybe that giant muumuu or blanket in the back.
Yeah.
So, do you care to explain why someone else's clothing is in your room? It's a little creepy.
Well, it is actually my clothing. It's clothing I wore when I was in high school. A lot of people don't know this. I was a little wafer. A small little man in high school. And I like to break out my high school clothes sometimes just to just remember the man who I was and the man who I am now.
Well, the men that you are now.
You know what? That's not what this... Let's get off this subject. What do you guys think of my room? Tidy or shitey?
Tidy.
It's tidy. I have to give credit where credit's due.
Yeah.
Brilly, you really cleaned up your room at least nicely. So, yeah, tidy.
Yeah, well, you see, no pizza boxes.
Not a single pizza box in sight. Although that may be one stuffed behind your desk there.
No, it's not a pizza. Don't worry about that.
You're on track to become a great cleaner someday.
Paul, would you care to make fun of Brillo's room? I mean, evaluate Brillo's room?
Yeah, well, you know, there's not much I need to do to make fun of Brillo. He's got that sorted out for him.
Well, that was awful nice of you. So, tidy or shitey?
Shmitey.
That'll work. And here is our next tidy or shitey. And I'm having a hard time evaluating this one. I'm very confused.
Yeah, Lewis, do you know anything about what's going on here?
Oh, yes. Well, this is an ice cream making station. You see the guy in the front is making pineapple ice cream. The guy a little behind him is making a sorbet, and the two people in the back aren't making ice cream. They're just standing there.
Oh,
I really would have thought that Brilly would have known more about this.
I'm not a big fan of ice cream.
So, you know, I'm looking at the floor here, and I believe that, okay, either this is spit spray on my monitor for me talking, or there may be some dirt on that floor, so I'm going to have to go 100% shitey. This room is shitey.
Yeah, I think I see some particles there, some dust.
Mm-hmm. This wasn't properly mopped. Right, Lewis?
Yeah, you know, definite lack of mopping in here. None of these guys are carrying a mop, therefore, totally shitey.
Yeah, shitey.
You guys think this is shitey? This seems immaculate to me. I vote tidy.
Whoa.
Whoa, and if I'm not mistaken, the bylaws of Mega Cleancast say that your vote counts for four, while ours count for one each. Therefore, this room is tidy.
What? Holy shit! Democracy strikes again.
This is rigged.
I'd like to change my vote.
I would also like to change my vote because I believe in voting with the majority all of the time. So, tidy.
Yep, tidy.
Hey, I have principles, and therefore I'm going to go with the group and say tidy.
It's unanimous. This one's tidy. So let's move on to our next area. Okay, this guy has a desk, I don't know, that's
some
a,
kind.
That's a pretty, that's a, that's not a tidy desk.
Yeah, that's a subpar desk.
It's pretty, I don't know if I can say it's shiny. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go shiny. This is shiny. It's super mess.
Yep. You look, know what? Even look behind the desk. There's just more clutter.
Yeah, way too many photos. And look, his computer that he obviously uses is buried somewhere under this stuff. You can't even get to it.
You know, I don't like that telephone being there. I think it should be in a different room. And therefore, mm-hmm. I'm going to say shitey.
My religion actually says that telephones have to be in a different room. So, very shitey.
Me too.
Oh, you guys have the same religion?
No, he also has to be in a different room. That's what he means. My religion says Lewis and telephones have to be in a different room than me. That's why we stuck him in a booth like Robin on the Howard Stern show. I was all for putting Brillo in that booth with his body smells, but, yeah, you know, religion.
My religion won't let me into any confined space.
Oh, what religion is that? Fat-assism?
I'm gonna punch some fats shists.
Well, okay. This man's desk is shiny.
This unknown man's desk is very shiny. In fact, it looks like some of the dirt has accumulated onto his face, as it is discolored.
I guess so. Yeah, I don't really know who that person is, so.
This man with the exceptionally small hands. Oh, that's probably the problem. He can't clean. His hands are too tiny.
You should probably just hire somebody.
Yeah, he obviously does not have any money. I mean, look. Just look at him.
Yeah.
Look at the chair he has.
But Mexicans are so cheap. Just hire some Mexican to do it for you.
You know, this looks like the guy who would love Mexicans, so we'll throw that idea out to him if we ever see him.
Yeah, we'll ask him.
So, yeah, shitey.
Yeah, shitey. A shitey, but, you know, with possible improvement in the future.
So, a shitey plus?
Yeah, shitey plus.
Shitey plus.
That's fair.
And that's going to bring us around to our last... Tidy or shitey. So for our final tidy or shitey, it's Lane, you mean nice Mr. Clean Maymay Man.
Oh, wow. So tidy.
This is some tidy goddamn shit, bro.
This is like the tidiest shit I've ever seen in my life.
I've never seen a tidier area than this area right here.
This area here is the tidiest.
Paul, what do you think? What do you think of this, Paul?
Yeah, Paul.
I'll go check on him, I guess. Paul? He broke a glass.
And while we wanted to carry on for the next 4 hours with more cleaning discussion, it sounds like Paul has made a mess.
Yeah, he's got to clean up his sticky, icky mess.
And that's just not going to cut it.
Hey, you know, we're the clean team. Maybe we should just join forces and clean it together.
Hey, that's a good idea. I'll go get...
Actually, I got Paul here.
I'll go get my Tide Pods.
I'll get my mop.
We're finishing
Billy,
the cast.
You just stay there, out of the way.
We're finishing the cast, Paul.
Yeah, I can hear.
Yeah.
I don't care. I don't suck dick and tell.